Okay, I will walk you over SAP Assignment 5 on Visual Composer. What is Visual Composer? Visual Composer is basically a modeling tool for building code-free applications. Visual Composer supports creating web-based applications by manipulating data elements such as data services and web services and user interface elements such as forms and tables. It also supports creating connections between elements, and it can also generate runtime code. Okay, now in SAP Assignment 5, what we will do is we will develop a web-based application for looking up sales order for a given customer. And in order to develop this application, we will be using a sales order BAPI. What is BAPI? BAPI is Business Application Programming Interface. Okay, now, so this is our first assignment on Visual Composer, where we will be building a web-based application without having to code, and this application is basically on looking up sales order for a given customer. So we will be using this URL that I have given you. Copy this URL and paste it in Internet Explorer browser and log in to this using the same ID and password that you have been using so far. So I have logged on using my own ID and password, and then I go to model, I go to new model. Okay, here be within composite view and then select a repository. I am selecting local repository. Okay, now name this in the development component, go to new, okay, and then give a name to your development component, and I have asked you to name it in a certain way. So come here and check and see what I have asked you to name. I have asked you to name the development component small s 5350 and then NNN, that's your user ID. So if you are LU002, you would be writing S5350002_NW5. Okay, and please note that this must be all lowercase. So let me come here. So I'll name it S5350. I'm using 002, so 002_NW5. Since I have practiced it before, I may already have a development component like this. So let me just put in something else here. So NW51, okay, so that I make it different than my other component. So say okay, and then give it a name. How do I name my new model? Also, I have given you an instruction on to how to name your new model. You will name it capital S5350NNN_sales order, where NNN is your login number. So I call it S5350002_sales order. Okay, and I say okay. So my model has been created. Okay, the next step will be for me to select a data service, and I will select R3 data service. For that I have to search. So let me go here, I go to search, I have to select the data service from here. I select R3 data service, and that system destination is OXF. Okay, so I will do that. And then I have to search for a BAPI, which is sales order. So let me look at that. So I would have an asterisk here and then sales order, and then I So these are all my business application programming interfaces available to me from SAP. Okay. So the one that I want to use is this one. I will use BAPI sales order get list. Okay. And I have to drag that to the work area. BAPI sales order get list. Okay. Drag that to the work area. So BAPI sales order get list is this one. So I drag it to my work area. Okay. After I do that, I have to define the ports. How do I define the ports? In the input port, I have to select customer number and sales organization. Okay. So in the input port, I have to select I click on the input port and see all of them have been selected. So I deselect all of them. And from then I select customer number and sales organization. Okay. Then I believe I do have to, on the output port, I have to select these four. Within sales order, within, you know, I have to go to output port, then I have to select sales order, and then within sales order, I have to select these four: creation date, plant, purchase number, and sales description document. So let's see. I right click and I go to redefine ports to get it back. And so here within sales order, I deselect all. And I select the ones that have been, let me show all. And then if I remember correctly, purchase number, plant, creation date, plant, and then what is the fourth one? Creation date, plant, purchase number, and SD document. So SD document. Okay. Okay, what else? Let me read it carefully, the things that I have to select. Okay. In the input port, I had to select input, and then I had to select customer number and sales organization. In the sales order, I had to select four of those things: creation date, plant, purchase number, and SD document, and that's about it. Okay. And then the next step will be to right click on the BAPI and select test data service, and I will have to allow pop-ups. So right click test data service. I think I have allowed pop-ups in the past, so it's not asking me for that. And then I have to do test. No data found, that's fine. I did not put in my values yet. Okay, then I have to click on input and enter the customer number. I have given you a customer number, so copy and paste it from here. And the sales organization number is 1020. And then I click on the test button. So I go to input and then customer number, control V, so is that, and sales organization is 1020. And then I test my data. And so you can see that it is pulling up this information about the sales document and all kinds of information. Okay, so I can close it now, and then what happens? See, so it's working basically. So now I will develop my own model. So I will drag the input port from the BAPI and onto the workset, and I will select the form view. So I'll select the input port, drag, I'll select the form view. Okay, now what happens in the form view? I will rename it basically by entering input customer data as 5350 NNN. Okay, So let me do that. So double click on that. Okay, double click, and then you can see input comes here. So leave that, you know, delete that, and I say enter customer data, and then I give the number. So I do that, enter customer data S5350002, that's my number. So you write down your own number. I'm using 002 because that's what I'm using right now. That's it. And so, and I entered that. Okay, so that shows here. And then what I need to do is I drag the sales order output port onto the workspace and select the table view. So I will do this one, and I will select the table view from here. Rename the table to sales order. Okay, so I will it is already, you know, named as sales order, so it's fine. And then I have to click on the layout button of the workspace, and then the layout button will appear, and then see what happens. So I click on the layout button, so it comes out this way. Okay, then let's see what we have to do. Then I have to deploy, and I have to check if it is working. So let me deploy the model. So I'll come here, I'll deploy the model. So I will say deploy. Okay, then it will return me the deployment was fine, and I will click on the flex. Okay, so this is my model, and I'm displaying trying to work on that. Okay, now customer number, let me put in the customer number and see if it is working. Okay, so the customer number that I would like to try, which is in the system, is this, and then sales organization is 1020. So let me see, put in that control V, this one, and sales organization is 1020, and I submit. So you can see that I can now see the sales document number, the purchase number, the plant, and the creation date corresponding to the customer 4030436 and sales organization 1020. Okay, so basically this allows me to look up for a customer. Okay, and then what you have to do is take a screenshot of this and paste it in your Word document. That's about it. Once you are here, and then you can go back to the design view, and then when you log off, it will ask you for saving, and please save it. And this screenshot is the one that you have to submit for your assignment file. Thank you.